The entire Christmas story seems to begin with a lot of questions. When the angel announced to Zechariah that his wife Elizabeth, long past childbearing years, would have a son, Zechariah asked, "How will I know this is so?" John the Baptist, the son who was the one sent to prepare the way for the coming of the Lord, asks the crowds that come to him along the way, "Who has taught you to flee the wrath that is to come?" The crowds that come to him ask him, "What should we do?" The angel appeared to Mary to announce that she was to conceive a child. When she heard the announcement, she too had her question. "How can this be, since I do not know man?" Elizabeth, when she was visited by Mary, proclaimed this question, "How is it that the mother of my Lord should come to me?" And then a little later on, the Magi directed this question to the wicked King Herod, "Where is the one that has been born King of the Jews?" These questions begin the Christmas drama, and they prompt me to ask some questions of you. Three questions. Who brought you here? I don't mean physically. You came in someone's car, I know. But who brought you to the faith that you have in the Son of God become man like us as a babe in Bethlehem? Who planted the seed of faith in you? Who's responsible for the fact that you're here tonight? Who marked you for Christ? Whose values do you follow? Connected to this question, I'm cheating, I'm adding some more questions. Whom are you marking, introducing to the faith? To whom are you passing on values? Second question, who holds you with love, with encouragement, and with affirmation? Who loves you beyond the imperfections in your character as well as in your appearance? Whose support do you lean on for guidance, for strength, and for help when it comes to doing the right thing? Of course, that leads to a follow-up question or two. Whom do you hold or should? Third and final question, the toughest of all, who are you? Who are you? Remember, who you are is what you do, not the other way around. What you do doesn't make you who you are, but who you are determines the kinds of things you do. If you know you are a child of God, for instance, full of dignity and worth, then you will do God-like things. So, in the tradition of the scriptures, I've left you with questions this night. Who brought you here? Whom are you bringing, or should? Who holds you in affirmation? Whom do you hold, or should? Who are you? Does that cause you to act the way you do, or should? Take comfort that the babe born in Bethlehem, our cause for gathering tonight, wants nothing more than to help us answer these questions, to be part of the answer, to direct us to the proper answer. He wants for his gift on his birthday that we see and know the beauty and goodness that is in each one of us because of him. From the very beginning, Christmas raises questions. From the very beginning, Christmas offers answers. May you all have the gift of faith, the blessing of hope, and the peace of Jesus' love this Christmas and always. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.